how to write a letter to the editor. In previous lectures, we learned what are letters to the editors, where they are published, what should be the length, and what are the protocols if we want to get a letter to the editor published. Today comes the writing part. We are going to learn how to write, like how the actual process of writing happens. Let's begin. All right, this is the first step. How do you select a topic? In my experience, many students mostly are confused about selecting a topic. I would like to repeat this information that I highly recommend my students of opinion writing to write a small write-up, which will maybe 300 words long maximum, and get it published in an international level publication. That is a kind of opinion piece which is easier to publish as compared to other pieces of opinion. And if you do that during this semester, which means before February the 12th, you will get 5 extra marks for your overall evaluation. So whenever I encourage students for that, the first question many students ask me, ma'am, I do not know from where to begin. Many persons come to me and they ask me this question. I have taught this course actually before, and I love teaching this course. I enjoy teaching this course because I am myself a writer. I wrote in The Nation, which is an English newspaper in Pakistan, when I was in the final year of my master's at Lahore College for Women University. So I have experience of working with newspapers, especially English newspapers, and I have also experience of getting articles published. And I am myself a writer. I like writing and I enjoy teaching this course. So that is why there are many things that I can actually share with you that are related to my experience. My experience of writing and my experience of teaching this course. So I was saying that whenever I encourage my students, I ask them that they should write something, especially for the letter to the editor section of the newspaper. The first question, many students come up with this concern that, ma'am, I am having trouble selecting a topic. How do I know what should I write about? Now, here is an explanation of what sort of topics you can choose and what are the tips that can help you choose a topic. Now, selecting a topic depends on a number of things. The first thing you can see I have mentioned on the screen is your personal inclination. What topics are important to you? What are you inclined towards? Like, are you inclined towards writing about social issues? Are you inclined towards writing about political issues? Are you inclined towards writing about, let's say, economic issues, issues related to sports, business, whatever it is? Everyone, all of us have our personal inclinations, our likings and dislikings. So first of all, it comes about the area, your area of interest, what you are actually interested in. Let's see what we have next. Then it also happens that you need to consider that whether you have grip or sufficient amount of knowledge about the topic that you want to write about. Sometimes it happens that we are interested in an area, interested about a particular area, but maybe we do not have sufficient knowledge to begin with. Let's say many of you may be interested in writing about fashion. When I was at your stage, I was really interested in writing about fashion when I was myself a bachelor's student. But when I thought about writing something on fashion or related to fashion, I realized that I did not have sufficient knowledge in this area. So you also need to consider that if you have sufficient knowledge on that area, like there are sometimes some topics that we can handle better. Do you agree to this? And sometimes there are, if I am a kind of person who sometimes, but almost all the times I do not pay attention to news related to sports. I do not read them. I do not even see that section in the newspaper. So And obviously, in that sense, I am a kind of person who is totally ignorant about this area. So if anyone, of course, asks me to write about something related to sports, that is not my thing. I do not have any knowledge. That is the kind of topic that I cannot handle. So there are sometimes topics that we feel like we can handle better. So it's actually about that. And then your background knowledge on a particular topic. It's again the same thing, like how much knowledge you already have about something. Your personal motivation. Sometimes it happens we are personally motivated to write about something. Let's say you live somewhere in an area which is in the suburbs of Lahore, and you commute to the city, you commute to the college for your classes every day. And we all know that traffic in the city is very bad, and also the public transport system, especially within Lahore, is not very good. So maybe you have different problems, and that is something which is you are experiencing right now, and that is something which is really, really close to your heart, and you feel motivated to write about it. Or maybe you are a student who lives in hostel. And you feel like, well, hostel life is a kind of life, a kind of student life that makes you more organized, that is really kind of, that keeps you motivated in the sense that you get inspiration from your fellow students or that kind of thing. And that is your experience and you want to talk about it. So selecting a topic also depends on your personal motivation. Any problem or issue that you are experiencing, I just gave you the example of commuting issue that anyone may have. It may be related to pollution, air pollution, noise pollution, water pollution. Let's say you live in an area and that area has many moss in the neighborhood, and people, you have been experiencing, let's say you have, I'm just imagining a situation that you have been experiencing unnecessary use of loudspeaker by people in your nearby mosque, and you are a student, that is something which is really disturbing for you. So this is about noise pollution and you want to write about it. You have an idea that there is no one who can actually regulate such things, the use of loudspeaker and everything. That is an issue, that is a problem that you have been experiencing lately, and you can write about it. Then you care about sharing. If you remember, those of you who were with us in the last class, and also when we did an activity this past week on Friday, I asked you to read 3 or 4 letters to the editor from a newspaper. And when we did this activity in the last class, there was this editorial which was about technology wonders, smartphone wonders, that was its title. And there was this woman who was talking about this idea that I have a maid.